Hi guys, this is Matai the Dead, and another episode of Mondo Squallido. For today's episode, we're sticking with Avon Productions, and we're actually sticking with the same director as last episode, Phil Prince. And today's film is from 1982, and it's a film called Angel in Distress. Which stars, I'd say in the lead role, Ron Jeremy, who a lot of you guys, whether you're into the adult films or not, you'll know who Ron Jeremy is. He's probably the most well-known living, porn actor to date, who's still active, but more in, low-budget horror films. But there's still stories floating about of his continued acts. And, of course, you can now also drink his, I think it's whiskey, which is very interesting. So, yeah, a lot of you guys know who Ron Jeremy is. Also in this film, we've got Mistress Candice in there, who, again, was in last week's episode, along with David Christopher. The fantastic George Payne is in this film as well. And a few of the Avon regulars are in there as well. All in all, this is a really entertaining film. Essentially, Ron Jeremy plays as a private detective who has, in typical 1980s adult films fashion, has a libido. And he's a self-confessed sex addict.
And I'm probably the horniest man this side of the Mississippi. In fact, if I could only keep my mind on my job and not on my privates, I'd be a much better private eye. It's a shame. What do you think, Cheryl?
Mm-hmm. And he is, for the most part, a genuinely funny character in this film. I thought he was hilarious. Some of the lines that he comes up with are just absolutely genius.
Swat!
What?
Oh, you feel so good. We got a case. Please, call me a taxi. I gotta get out of here.
And basically, he's been called to find a missing girl by the name of Angel, by the father and the stepmother. So, the first scene, we get a little bit of an introduction from Ron Jeremy's character.
New York is a place where money can buy you anything. From a good time with a woman, to a good time with a man. Whatever your fetish is, New York has the remedy.
Then we cut to a really awesome title sequence, some great typography, a little bit of a side note, with a fantastic score in the background, which, again, is probably lifted from a lot of other sources, as is the case with films of this nature. So it's off to a really great start. It's got an almost sinister feel to it. But I'd say that this film is, for the most part, a comedic film. There is a few scenes in there which are, supposed to be disturbing. But overall, this is, again, another very tongue-in-cheek, adult film from the early 80s. So Ron Jeremy gets a call about, a missing girl. He goes over to the house of the parents where he gets involved with the mother. A little bit of, one-to-one support, shall we say. And this is, these scenes are intercut with scenes of Angel getting gang raped by George Payne, Dave Christopher, and there's one more guy whose name escapes me right now. And this is probably the most disturbing part of the film, but as is the case with scenes of this nature, you can't really feel the sinister, you know, vibes, because the actress playing Angel seems more than willing to take. And it's happened in a lot of films where there's, you know, a gang rape scene or a rape scene in general. You know, the woman actresses usually always look a bit too into it. And of course, they're acting, of course, you know, that's what they do. So along with some, again, hilarious dialogue from Dave Christopher, who looks totally drugged off his face in this scene.
Oh, yeah, you suck it now. You're gonna get this cock real hard, because I'm gonna shove it down your cunting asshole.
We get, you know, just a typical, you know, three guys, they're playing with this girl, you know, George Payne is the one who's actually, you know, doing the business, the rest are just, you know, the other two guys are having their, you know, dicks sucked and playing with her breasts and all that sort of thing. Then keeps coming back to Ron Jeremy fucking the stepmother, which is just hilarious because Ron Jeremy is just being Ron Jeremy and coming up with these really funny, you know, lines of dialogue.
Ooh, you are the best. You are the best.
Then it cuts back to the gang rape where we see slow motion cum shot with the title song from Halloween, albeit a very Moog-based Halloween track. And I have to say that it sounds pretty good and it goes with the scene. Again, it's supposed to be disturbing, but you don't really get that vibe. Once Ron Jeremy's finished the business, he discovers that the woman is, you know, she gives him, well, she drops a escort service card, which he finds very mysterious. So, of course, he's straight on with the case, goes back to his office, goes back to the gangbang, where we are introduced to Mistress Candice, playing, of course, Mistress Candice. She basically owns, like, you know, she does live sex shows, again, Avon, you know, in their theatres, they'd show, you know, really sleazy, low-budget hardcore flicks, and then in the intermissions, they'd have, you know, live sex acts. So, yeah, Mistress Candice, being Mistress Candice, she's making her slaves suffer for, coming all over Angel, and then, of course, she, you know, does a lot of stuff to Angel. It's a pretty bog standard forced S&M stuff. It's very dialogue based, you know, she's playing the whole, you know, mistress, madam, you know, dominant card a lot, which is, you know, she does this in pretty much every film that she's been in. And that's what she's good at. She's good at playing the bitch, you know, ordering her dogs and her slaves to do her work for her, and all the while saying that she absolutely hates what she's seeing and all that sort of stuff. So that's pretty standard affair. So then we go back to the office where Ron Jeremy asks one of his staff to basically become an employee for this escort service.
You have to go to the Sun Escort Agency and take a job there. I don't do any... what you do best, probably.
We cut back to Mistress Candice being Mistress Candice.
And you just come without my permission. Without even one little thought of how I'm going to feel about it.
Then it goes to the woman working with Ron Jeremy's character, who, if I'm the one who explained earlier, is called Amos. I remember hearing people calling him Anus. Probably the intentional joke there, anyway.
I'm Amos Bragg, and I carry a badge. I also carry a very large dick.
She goes into, you know, for the position where she basically gets caught having a device strapped to her chest, which for some reason makes bleeping sounds. It looks like a tape recorder. It's just so ridiculously done, it's rather laughable. As punishment, she's part of the, you know, final big sex scene. This film is only an hour long. There's not really that many different scenes in this. So, you know, it's not like a feature length thing or anything like that. There's, I'd say, about three or four acts, if you will. So we cut to, you know, the big finale, you know, where there's the live sex show. Footage from this scene can be seen in Pain Mania. It's Avon recycling footage for different purposes. So there's really nothing new in this one. We get treated to Ron Jeremy undercover as a pizza guy.
Look, man, I'm a working man. If somebody ordered pizza, I'm bringing you pizza. Please sign right here. Thank you.
Why not? I guess we can use a little food.
Very pretty lady. I like your outfit, by the way.
He gets discovered by someone who I'm not going to reveal it. There's a nice little twist in this film. And then as part of his punishment, he basically has to do what Ron Jeremy does best and fuck a woman. The whole thing gets stopped because police break in, and yeah, that's basically the story. It's pretty standard. I'd say this film would make a good companion piece to Carter Stevens's punk rock. Carter Stevens' punk rock is, of course, a superior film out of the two. But all in all, it's a fairly entertaining film. Like I said, I think they tried to go for a disturbing film, but it just comes off as very comical. Not like unintentionally, there's some obviously, you know, intentional comedic parts to this film. But I think it's slightly, you know, tipping the balance in comedy, especially with the scenes with Ron Jeremy, who steals the, you know, scene in every scene that he's in, as is the case with pretty much 99.9% of every Ron Jeremy, you know, orientated film. So yeah, if you like Ron Jeremy, if you like, again, very tongue-in-cheek, hardcore flicks, then this is one for you. Some people might find rape scene a bit hard, but for those people who are looking for extreme, you know, sick stuff, the rape scene isn't, you know, it isn't exactly, you know, PG-13 or toned down, but at the same time, it's not really menacing at all. It's, you know, because again, you can't take the actress seriously playing, you know, Angel, because she doesn't seem to really be putting any resistance whatsoever. But again, that's, you know, pretty standard affair. But all in all, it's a pretty enjoyable flick. Got a great score with lots of lifted music and uses of John Carpenter's Halloween theme music, which I think this is like the third film that I've seen that has used an interpretation of the Halloween theme tune. But yeah, I enjoyed it. Again, just leave your brain at the door if you want just like a good little entertaining hour. There's nothing really fap-worthy in this film, as is, you know, the case with films from this period nowadays. But I enjoyed it. Some great dialogue from Ron Jeremy. The sex scenes are pretty standard. But there are some nice parts to the whole bondage stuff with Mistress Candice. She's awesome in this as well. Gets a bit annoying at times with her accent that she puts on. It's very strange. But all in all the performances are pretty strong. It's just got a good feel to it. I enjoyed it. And it's not the greatest adult feature, but then again, I've seen a lot more worse and boring titles. And again, it's got Ron Jeremy in it, so, you know, whether you like Ron Jeremy or not, it, you know, he's entertaining in everything he's been in, whether it be, you know, the hardcore stuff or his more recent, you know, horror films. But yeah, I enjoyed it. It's stuff that you've seen before, done much better. But at the same time, it's not going to be a film that you're going to just brush off. It's got some replayability, but all in all, it's worth a watch if you guys can seek it out. Again, this is from the Avon Dynasty's box set brought out by Alpha Blue Archives. I don't know whether it's got its own separate release from Alpha Blue or some other distribution company. But it's definitely worth researching. If I find any links, they'll all be down below. That's my review of Angel in Distress, directed by the infamous Phil Prince from 1982. That's it for now. If you've seen this film, as always, let me know what you thought of it. If you've got any questions, feel free to ask. But all the links that I'll be putting down below should answer any questions that you've got. Before I go, Mondo Squallido videos are hosted up on Blogomatic 3000, which is Flimdar here on YouTube, his website. I'll put the link down to his YouTube and also to the website itself for you guys to go check it out. As always, go check out Mondo Squallido on Facebook. And until the next time, guys, you're all awesome, and stay sleazy.
Take my big cock.
Oh.
You like it, huh?